हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी सम मोर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ वेक्टर्स एंड मैट्रिक्स फंक्शंस। बिफोर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू ओपन ए न्यू स्क्रिप्ट, ब्लैंक स्क्रिप्ट फ्रॉम हेयर। सो वी कैन राइट एनी कोड और कमांड इन कमांड विंडो पैनल, और वी कैन राइट इन दिस न्यू स्क्रिप्ट। Also, we can drag and drop any panel to anywhere on this interface. Suppose if I want to drag this window to here, then this command window is visible to parallel to this editor. This percentage sign is used for comment. Tutorial from Sumit. Enter. Now we should save it first. We can save it anywhere. I am saving it at the desktop. We can write here any name, testing file, and save it. Now we can have one or two examples of trigonometric functions. Suppose we want to know the value of sin pi by 2 and cos pi by 2, then we can write here sin pi by 2. So as we know, we can write pi as pi, pi. For pi we have value 3.14, then we should save it here and then run. Now it is asking to change the folder, add to path, cancel or help. So for to run this file, we should change the path as a add to path. So now we are getting the value of sin pi by 2 is equal to 1. Now we will look for another value of cos pi by 2 and then again save and then run it. So the value of cos pi by 2 is given as 6.1232 into 10 raised to power minus 17. So the expected value of cos pi by 2 to be 0. But MATLAB is a numerical package and the answer is very close to 0. Now I am commenting another thing. Use of command format long. Enter. We can use this command format long, which gives the more digits to the decimal point. Means this command format long is used to put more values after the decimal point. Suppose we can see default values are 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 after the decimal point. Now we can see here format long and then run. Again see what is the value of cos pi by 2 and then run. So now also we can see from here we are getting more than 4 values after the decimal point. So this is our decimal point and we can see it is given more than 4 values. We can clear this command window by using CLC and then run it. So we can either use this run tab or we can also press function F5 to run this code. Now we will see element wise operation. Element wise operations. Now let us have any vector A which is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, bracket closed, and then enter. Now if we do multiplication, that is we can do multiplication by using A into A and then run it. So it is showing incorrect dimensions for the vector or matrix multiplication. That is, A into A won't work due to the incompatibility in the dimensions of matrix or vector. So we can see the multiplication of two vectors is not working here. So we can comment out it. Now we can do element wise multiplication. For that we use the symbol dot star. That means A dot star A, and then run it. So now we can see this is our row vector 1 2 3 4, and multiplication of A into A gives you 1 4 9 16. We can again clear command window here. Also we can use the following symbol A dot raised to power 2 and then run it. So it will also give you the same results. Means when we multiply A by A, then it will give you 1 4 9 16. Suppose now we have any row vector T equal to bracket 0.1 comma 4 comma 5 comma 2.2, bracket close, and then enter. Now I wish to use some vector functions. Suppose I want to see the max of t value, maximum of t value. Then we will use max of t row vector and then run it. So this is our maximum value of vector t, 5. So we can see 5 is the maximum value. Also we can see the minimum of t vector. It is 0.1, this value. We can also arrange in increasing order by using the command sort, and this is our vector t. So by using it we can see minimum value is 0.1 and then it is increasing to 0.2 and then 4 and then 5. So this row vector is written in increasing order by using the command sort t. Another command is mean of t row vector. So it will give you the mean of this vector. So it comes approximately 2.825. These commands can also be applied to the matrices. CLC to clear the command window. Let us have any matrix capital A equal to 1.4 2 5 semicolon 4 1 8 semicolon 7 8 9 bracket closed, and then enter, run it. So it is a 3x3 matrix. So here we can see after each decimal point we have many number of values, so we can again reset this to up to the 4 decimal values. So by using the format sort command. Again we have to write this vector here, control C, control B, run it. So now we can see here, so I am getting the a matrix which have 3 rows and 3 columns, so 1.4 2 5 4 1 8 7 8 9. So maximum of matrix A will give you the values 7 8 9, which is maximum in third row. Again we can have maximum of our answer. So maximum value of our answer is 9. Also we can comment out both the command here, and we can approach direct steps, like we can use max of matrix A and then run it. So again we can see we got the matrix A and the answer is 9. Suppose if we want to do the section, then we can insert from here. It give you the separate section. That means you can see here one line, means above this line this code will not work because we have given double percentage sign here, so it separate the section. Now we will look for matrix functions. Suppose if we want to make the identity matrix, then we can use I function, and we can make it as a 3x3 matrix, means 3 rows and 3 columns. So run it. So we can get 3x3 identity matrix. Matrix of 0, 3, 3, we got the matrix of zeros. Matrix of 1, so it has 4 rows and 4 columns. Now if I want to clear this, now let us have any matrix A, semicolon, semicolon, run it. So we got the matrix of 3 rows and 3 columns. Now if we want to the extract diagonal of this matrix, then we can use the command diag diag of this matrix A. So it will give you the diagonal of this matrix A 159. If we want upper triangular part of the matrix, then we can use TRIU true of matrix A and then run it. So it will give you the upper triangular part 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 9, and rest of the things are zeros. For the lower triangular part of the matrix, we can use trill of matrix A. So we can see from here, so this is our lower part 1, 4, 7, 8, 9 or 5. So 1, 4, 7, 8, 9 or 5. Suppose if we want to generate a random matrix, then we can type RAND and then run. So it will give you the value 0.8147, means it has one rows and one column, or either we can have 3x3 matrix which generate a random matrix and then run it. So we can see here we got the a random matrix which have 3 rows and 3 columns.